what happens. And in September, I gave them a single pitch and they dutifully sang it and then just kind of looked at me for direction after that. And then slowly, you know, one or two singers would come up with maybe a little rhythm to go with it or a little melody. We just kind of kept working on it over the course of the year, up till about 2 weeks ago when I said, you know, it'd be kind of cool to start a concert with a circle song. And they were like, okay. So all I did was give them a starting pitch and then they just made up a song. So thank you for your bravery and for going along with my silly idea. So now I'm going to turn to some music that was written down. The first piece is by contemporary American composer Eric Whitaker, who about 15 of the students on stage worked with last year. We went to a long weekend event in New York with about 200 other high school and college age singers from across the country and worked with Eric Whitaker for 3 days, and it culminated in a concert at Carnegie Hall. We're looking forward next year, in March of 2020, to doing a similar event with composer Ola Yalo, whose Eche Novo we heard on our winter concert. So we're super excited about that. This piece is called The Seal Lullaby, and in the liner notes, Eric talks about how he was asked to write this piece based on Rudyard Kipling's story called The Seal Lullaby, which was being pitched to a major film company as an animated movie. So he wrote the song originally just for soprano and piano and submitted it and was super excited about the project. And then weeks went by and he never heard anything. And he thought, oh no, what did I do wrong? And he finally got up the nerve to call and find out what happened. And they said, oh, we love your piece, but we're making Kung Fu Panda instead. So he was really bummed and didn't know what to do with this piece. And then eventually was commissioned to turn it into a choral setting. And it's like one of his most popular pieces. And in a full circle moment, he worked on music for Kung Fu Panda 3. So it was a win-win. But we really love this piece, and we hope you do too. This is Seal Lullaby by Eric Whitaker.
Thank you.
wonderful song that was featured in a 1999 movie called Dil Se. And the title of the song is Dil Se Re. You have a translation in your program. It's by the composer A.R. Rahman. And we just had a ton of fun singing this. We listened to a bunch of different arrangements online and kind of came up with one that worked for us. We performed it in March at the Bollywood Assembly, and we're excited to share it with you as well. You'll notice that the lower voices are sort of our bass line and percussion, and then the upper voices have the Hindi text. So this is Dil Se Re.
Bye.
have one more duet for you. This is Kathy and Blair singing a beautiful song called Flight by the musical theater composer Craig Carmelia. This was not actually written for a musical, but it was written for the Broadway actress Sutton Foster for an album that she put out, and she sang it with her co-star from the musical Little Women, Megan McGinnis. So if you want to hear the original recording, look for Sutton Foster singing Flight, but actually you won't have to because they're everyone's here.
We are the Foxtones, Quaker's first premier a cappella group. founded in 1845 by George Fox himself. So we'll be performing two songs. First one is Stand By Me.
Yeah.
say one thing. The Grace Notes chose their repertoire, and we were commenting on how sort of girl anthems have changed a lot in the past 50 years. Mr. Postman is all about, you know, please, 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 why hasn't he called me? Why hasn't he written to me? And then their second song, Wings, is, you know, girl power. So just sort of noticed that we thought it was sort of interesting and fun, the difference in sort of girl groups in the past 50 years and how the messaging has changed.
Postman again, see,
oh,
is there a letter in Oh,
actually just performed on Thursday this past week at the all-school assembly with singers from grades 4 through 12 together, sort of a 1FCS choir. And the lower and middle school students sang a part that you're going to sing tonight. It's really easy. It'll be great. And the chorus will help you out when they're not doing other things. The piece is called Love is Love is Love is Love. And it has a couple of references in it. The title, although the composer Abby Batinas doesn't explicitly say so, I'm pretty sure that it's a nod to Lin-Manuel Miranda and his Tony speech, where, of course, instead of a speech, he delivered a sonnet to his wife, because that's what people do for Lin-Manuel Miranda. And he said, love is love is love is love, as part of his speech. The part that we're going to teach you in a minute is sort of a nod to All You Need Is Love by the Beatles. You'll hear a part that gets passed around through the choir in Latin, Ubi Caritas et Amor, which is, you know, a century-old chant, which means where there is charity and love, God is there. And this was written in 2017. It's part of a songbook called the Justice Choir Songbook. It's music, mostly new music, but some old standards like The Shall Overcome that are intended to be used freely at concerts and social justice events and rallies. And the composer wrote, the song is dedicated to the victims and survivors of hate crimes everywhere, and specifically for those at Pulse Nightclub in Orlando on June 12, 2016. Love is often the bravest thing we do. May love prevail. So, we're going to teach you your part. It's called the mantra. And then the chorus is going to keep singing that part, and then you'll hear slowly, sort of one section at a time, they'll move into some other parts, and we invite you to keep the mantra going. And then when they finish their other parts, they're going to return to the mantra until we're all singing it together again at the end. So let's teach you the mantra.
We need is love.
Okay, so just a couple bits of business before we invite alums and faculty and staff who would like to sing with us to join us for our final piece. I wanted to let you know that we will have a reception just across the way in the dining hall. Cookies and Passover-friendly treats as well. I got you covered. I definitely want to thank Zach, our esteemed
four co-presidents of choruses here. So we have just a couple pieces of business to take care of. So let's start with Scott.
These are for Galen. So thank you so much. Like, within these past, like, 4 years that I've been here, you help us out with note plate, and you put on the piano, and that's a lot. That's a good talent. It's just what we need. So, thank you so much. Yeah.
These flowers are for C.J. Keller.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Cookies and Passover treats and stuff. I'll see you after.